Now, in this video, I'm going to deal with while loop. I'll start my Visual Studio. File, New Project, Console Application, While Loop. While Example. While loop is used whenever we have the situation of indefinite iteration. That means if number of iterations are unknown prior to execution, we go for while loops. I'll just write a simple while loop. Say I have int I equals 0. I'll write while, I'll write the condition while I less than 10. And I want to display a message console dot write line Manzoor the trainer. And here I'll say I plus plus. It looks similar to your for loop, but to understand, we are using while loop to implement this task, because if number of iterations are known prior to execution, we should go with for loop. While loop is specially designed for those iterations which are unknown prior to execution. Now I'll put a breakpoint. It's very simple and straightforward. I value will be 0. And it will check the condition 0 less than 10, that's true. It will execute the statement and I value gets incremented. Then again it jumps to the condition, checks the condition, okay, 1 less than 10, that's true. It will execute the statement, then again increment the value of I value will become 2, and again it jumps to the condition, and this happens as long as the I value remains less than 10. So it is going to execute this for the 10 time. Okay, now we will try to look into one more example. Say for example, I have an integer n 5674. I have an integer n 5674 and I want to display the sum of all the digits. It's a simple program. Using while, I can implement this. While n not equals to 0, I'll perform my operations, and here I'll declare my sum as a variable whose value I'll initialize to 0. If n value is 0, say the number I'm giving it directly, but even I can read the number from the keyboard, in that case I do not know the value of n. If the value of n is 0, then the sum will be definitely 0. So I'll just come out of this while loop, and here I'll display sum console dot write line my sum is sum, value of sum. I'll just use console.readline. Now the logic is very simple. Logic is very simple. I need to declare one more variable here, int r. The logic is I'll take the digits one after the other from the right side by applying modulus, that is I'll try to find out the remainder by dividing it by 10. I'll get the last digit. Then I'll shorten this number by dividing this by 10, which will be the quotient. So I'll be using the simple logic of remainder and quotient to implement this. So first of all, I'll try to find out the remainder. Remainder equals to n mod 10. This will give me in first iteration it will give me 4, and my sum will be sum equals to sum plus this remainder. Now I need to short this number to 3 digits, to 5, 6, 7. So I'll say my new number equals to number by 10. That's it. This is a simple logic. In my first iteration, I'll take 4 and my new number will be 567. In the second iteration, I'll take 7 and my new number will be 56. In the third iteration, I'll take 6 and my new number will be 5. In fourth iteration, I'll take 5 and my new number will be 0. Then that will be my sum. So while is the best iterative statement that can be used to implement such kind of problem where number of iterations are unknown prior to execution. Just I'll put a breakpoint and let's check this. Now if you observe this, value of n is 567, which is not equals to 0, that is true. It jumps into the loop. Now I am trying to find out the remainder, so my remainder will be 4. That means I am trying to get the last character. So r should contain 4, right? Now my sum is 0, sum plus r. Now my new sum will be 4. Now if we see, the number is 5, 6, 7, 4. Now I want to remove this 4th last digit and I want to make my new number as 567. So divide by 10, the result will be 567. Fine. So in this way it undergoes 4 iteration. See that? Why? Because we have hard coded the number. So prior to execution we knew that it is going to undergo 4 iterations. Now let us see the sum. Sum is 22. 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 4. 11, 18, 22. Let's press F5. Sum is 22. Now if I read the value from the keyboard that we have seen, in dot parse console dot read line, I'll just press F5. Now it is asking me to give the number. I'll give a number. Now you see that as many number of digits I want I can give in my int range. So it depends upon the end user. So depending upon that, it need to execute the loop. So number of iterations are unknown prior to execution. So in this situation, I am going with while loop. Sum is 32. So this is all about your while loop, its syntax and how it works and when we are going to use while loop. Thank you.